What's up, everybody? Welcome back to The Last of Us Part 2. Last time as Ellie, we've been holed up in a synagogue for about 3 weeks. Don't worry, ladies and gentlemen, I will stick with this game for the long haul. This will be my second longest playthrough ever. Right next to Final Fantasy IX, that was 49 parts. And I think that will be the longest playthrough ever. And this one will be the second one. The Ellie segments will pick up steam as soon as we get to Saravina Hotel. This whole open world segment is just slow on repeat playthroughs.
Does it help?
I think it calms me. Helps me put things in perspective. It's a way to deal with grief. A way to show respect. It's what I know.
What's this?
Oh, this is the Torah.
The what?
It's scripture. It's like a Jewish Bible.
Hmm.
My sister would have flipped for this. The one we used in New Mexico was half burnt. All right. Well, at least I didn't just chuck everything.
We got more character building with Ellie and Dina. This is a really good couple, and what happens to them later on is, ooh, goddamn, that is a lot. But we'll get to that later. Way later. Now we're going to do some Indiana Jones rope swinging. This mechanic was taken straight off Uncharted 4, and it shows. So last month was the 1 year anniversary of this game's release, and it's safe to say that this fan base is still pretty split. But there are some detractors that are becoming more and more, I guess, understanding of the game, even though they still don't like it. But again, this is a very polarizing game.
5774? Are we in the future?
No, doofus, that's a Hebrew calendar. For the new year, my sister used to give me an apple dipped in honey. Ugh. Now I'm craving it.
Oof, that does sound pretty good.
Jewish holidays are all about food. And celebrating not getting annihilated by our enemies.
A long line of survivors.
Exactly.
Okay, next stop, courthouse. There are a lot of goodies in the courthouse. There are also infected in the courthouse, but luckily they don't have body armor like they did in the bank.
Okay, cross the dome off the list.
Let's go find the courthouse. It might be worth grabbing some supplies before we press on.
I already have a whole bunch of supplies, though. My backpack is full.
It's peaceful out here, at least.
It's weird being in a QZ and not hearing trucks. Or gunfire and explosions.
My sister always avoided QZs. That's probably why. She just got more and more paranoid. She'd sometimes wake up screaming in the middle of the night.
That's rough.
We always had a backpack so we could bail if something happened. Never stayed in one place for more than a few weeks. It sucked.
Wouldn't you just go to the countryside during a zombie apocalypse? I mean, that's a viable option. There's not really that many people on the countryside like that. Living in the city would be more detrimental because A, there's 1,000 people here, and B, martial law. No, not that martial law, no! But yeah, those were my 2 cents on surviving the apocalypse. Anyway... oh, it's just a note. Wait a minute. It just leads back to the bank. What the hell? Okay, so the good thing about this place here is that there's a workbench, so I could upgrade my guns right here. What I do is usually upgrade the shotgun first or the standard pistol, since I'm going to be using those the most. And also because the shotgun is a brutal weapon and I just want to add to that brutality by upgrading it. Man, the weapons in this game look good. I don't know how Naughty Dog keeps detailing everything, but They're doing something right here. They are the masters of real-time animation and overall realism. I want to know how they do it. I really want to know how they do it. This grass right here. This grass looks good, even though YouTube's probably compressing the shit out of it. And it's also probably due to me recording with less than decent software. I know. I'm recording like it's 2015 or something. Next, I'm going to the record store, which is kind of an optional place. You don't have to go here, but there is a kind of important cutscene here that you will miss if you do pass it by.
Man. Imagine this place when everything was intact.
They got a bunch of records here. The Sleek Habit.
The Sick Habit.
Close enough.
Okay. We only listened to it like 100 times together.
I was only listening to it because I thought you were cute.
You can go into this room and play little tunes. I'm sure you can play Mr. Sandman on the guitar. And play just about anything on the guitar.
What was that?
Nothing.
Well, nothing sure sounds nice.
Remember that night by the bonfire?
Yeah.
Ah.
He should have kissed me then. I wanted to. Me too. All right. We should keep moving.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Take On Me, performed by Ellie Williams. And a copyright claim. Dina will also play her own tune as well, and it may not be as good as Ellie's, but to each their own. You just go to a drum set somewhere in this building. I don't know where it is. I think it's in the downstairs. There it is. The drum set. The fabled drum set. We can hit the drums ourselves too. Take our frustrations out on those drums. Because in a minute, we'll be taking our frustrations out on the WLF.
Yo, check this out. Oh, wow, That was an interesting beat. Excuse me. I am a natural.
Boo! You stink!
I love you. Whatever. We're starting a band. How about you be my groupie?
Your what?
Well, okay. Fans apparently had these hardcore fans that would just follow them around.
Okay, that's enough of that. Let's actually go for what we were looking for. The gasoline. And this will be the last building we go before we actually end this little open world Seattle part.
It's nice to have a place.
Again, like I said, this part drags.
Yeah. When I first got to Jackson, I was so overwhelmed by all the people. I was overwhelmed by all the food. I remember my first week just gorging myself. Stuffing food in all my pockets for later like it was gonna run out.
I saw that. You did not. I did. I remember thinking, who is this string bean girl stealing all the jerky?
I didn't steal that much jerky.
You know, people in universe says that Ellie's skinny, but goddamn does she actually swing really hard. Especially with a pipe or a baseball bat. The girl can lay the smackdown on people. I'm sure Ellie would have been a good baseball player or tennis player in a past life or something. But alas, Ellie was born 5 years too late and everything went to shit by then. Oh, whoa, what's going on with the floor textures here? That was awkward. Okay, so maybe there were some oversights on the graphics, but everything still looks good. I just want to know how it looks on the PS5, though. Oh well. By the way, the safe behind that FEDRA gate has the same number code as the gate itself. But we're gonna get to that safe at the end of this video. For right now, let's get back to Shimmer.
Ellie, I think Shimmer's getting sick.
What? How can you tell?
She sounds a little hoarse. Hey.
Okay, if Ellie's groaning at puns, there's something definitely wrong here.
See that sign up there? On the building that says courthouse?
Oh, well, nice work, detective.
Mm-hmm. Mark this place on the map.
Oh, I have a sinking suspicion that that map is gonna bite you so hard in the ass later on. But we're not at that part yet. And besides, Ellie's gonna take her revenge and everything will be just fine? With air quotes and a big old question mark? Times three? Fine? I don't know. yeah, we don't know.
This is gonna suck, isn't it?
That's what she said. I mean, what? But no, there are infected inside this building, so be prepared. Going up these stairs right here will just lead you to a note with some supplies, but that's really about it. Or I should say, lack thereof supplies here, because there's only one supplement and maybe a rag, and that's about it. It's probably even worse on harder difficulties in that there's no supplies here, because it's a harder difficulty. Well, I can craft something now. I'm just gonna do another Molotov, because if I play correctly, I really shouldn't be getting hurt at all. Or at least, very little. And besides, this game just gives you free health packs on certain occasions. So we're just gonna go up the ladder, go to the left, and through the window. After we collect more stuff. Okay, there's no more stuff. Let's just go through the window. Just like with almost every infected I deal with, you just sneak up on this guy and give it a low poke with your knife. And if I'm not mistaken, I think there is one more clicker in this room, right after this guy, and two or three runners. The runners are not really a problem, you could just dispatch of them really quickly. Come here, I gotcha! Man, Ellie's kills in this game are freaking brutal. And that's probably an understatement, because just about every other kill in this game is equally as brutal. But like I said before, this is Naughty Dog, and they're the kings of realism. Every game after Uncharted has gone towards a more realistic approach, so this was to be expected. Now, don't get me wrong, I do like some of the grittier aspects of this game as compared to the first game, but it also seems that other grittier aspects weren't as well implemented as they were in the first game, if you know what I mean. It's mainly having to do with the cycle of violence theme that they were going for in this game. The message is a bit muddied. And I think that was supposed to be the point for it to be that muddied, because it's not really about hatred, it's more about forgiving, but you already killed 1,000 or so people, and yet you forgive somebody. I'm not gonna spoil it, but we're getting there. I gotta have my revenge! But that guy didn't really do anything to you. I still must have my revenge! Get to the perpetrator. Okay, I forgive you. What?! But I do like some of the darker elements, like Ellie's further spiral into psychosis, and then there's stuff with Abby too, and we're gonna get to that later, but it gets interesting, trust me. Everything gets interesting after this point forward. And there's also ways you can go about this game too. You can kill everybody, you could do a somewhat pacifist run, even though you still have to kill certain people. And you either go stealth or balls to the wall, it's your choice.
Is that it? I think so. Go team. Let's find that gas. Yeah. I wonder what it was like to serve on a jury. But it was fun. Sit down. Look at evidence. Try to tell if somebody's lying.
Just give me 5 minutes of my knife. I'll tell you if they were lying or not.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Hey, a little help?
Coming. You ever been to a courthouse before?
Nope.
You're telling me you never got in trouble back in Boston?
Oh, I got in trouble. But never landed in a courthouse.
I don't think post-apocalyptia would have any use for courtrooms. Like, at all. But it doesn't matter what courtrooms are used for, we gotta find this gas.
Parking garage.
Well, the gas is in there, right?
Well, that's what the note said.
Well, let's get down
there. Hold on, I don't want to get down there yet. I just need more ammo. Can't go into a gunfight without, you know, a gun. Or a machete. Ah, yes, the famous old machete. The sword does not one-hit kill everybody like it did in the first game, but you can still do some massive damage with this thing.
This guy was a FEDRA commander or something. They were losing to the WLF and trying to escape.
How big is this group if they were able to beat the army?
Well, you don't need a lot if you're that vicious. We need to be careful.
Let's just be smart about it.
Okay, Jesse.
Okay, so now we know that the WLF is massive. So massive to take out the army. But apparently not massive enough to take out a 19-year-old skinny girl. Yeah, logic. Apparently Ellie was trained to take on large groups of people. Oh. Maybe she was trained by Liam Neeson. I swear, every movie Liam Neeson's in, he's always kicking somebody's ass. I don't get it. He's like 60 years old now. But it doesn't matter. What matters is me getting the safe open. I think I saw a safe combination here somewhere. Oh no, it's right here actually. Or not, maybe the safe combo is somewhere else. They're not always going to be on letters. You just have to look at your surroundings if you can't find it on a piece of paper. It could be written in blood, it could be found on a whiteboard. Like, right here. How did I forget that was here? Oh well, now I know. Get out of the way, Dina. I need to collect more stuff. The combo for this particular safe is 860722. And they don't change. Once you get the safe open, you're gonna get a lot of supplements, and I think some gears too, some supplies for your guns. Or parts, the things for your guns are called parts. Now that we scoured everything on this top level right here, let's go downstairs. Somehow the staircase is blocked off, so we have to use the elevator, but the cars are not working. So we're just gonna have to slide down the old-fashioned way. As soon as Ellie and Dina get downstairs, all bets are off. The infected are gonna be on high alert. And that's why the machete was upstairs, so it could give you a fighting chance against some of the clickers here. They will go down in 2 to 3 swipes with the machete. But I also have enough ammo to keep them at bay. Oh god. Thanks, Dina. But honestly, none of that matters because I have the shotgun. And all of life's problems seem to disappear with the shotgun. With the infected taken care of, the gasoline is going to be somewhere near the garage doors. Right there.
And? Wait. We got gasoline.
Good!
My luck's changing.
Don't you jinx us. The fuck FEDRA gate is calling to us.
Now, how do we get out of here?
Oh. Oh good, this open world part is over. Now we can actually move on. Oh my goodness. I'm just thinking to myself, because the rest of the game picks up and is pretty good, but this part, as well as the end of the game, just drags on, and I'm just like, oh my god, damn it, shit man, just get to the point already.
Let go.
job, babe.
Thanks.
Okay, gate.
Could be a while before we run into Abby and her friends. It might be worth grabbing some supplies before we press on.
Good point.
Onward, Shimmer.
How you doing back there? Getting homesick?
A little bit. You?
Same. Miss having a roof over my head.
You know, I've always dreamed of fixing up a farm just outside of Jackson.
Why wouldn't you stay in town?
I don't know. I like the idea of real space.
Sounds lonely.
Only if you're doing it alone.
Okay. So are we gonna, like, raise sheep and milk cows?
Are you making fun of me?
No. It actually sounds kind of nice.
Really?
Yeah. Really.
Farm life, eh? That might be a bit of foreshadowing. Or just some far-fetched dream, I don't know. Now I'm gonna have to look at this gate number list to see which gate corresponds with this safe. It is 0451, and this is the only safe in the game that has two combinations, not three. And there's also a side note in the back too. The only thing that's important on this note is that there's a big operation with Isaac, and that's going to happen later on, much later on. Alright, I'm checking this list again to make sure the safe actually corresponds, and we should be good to go. Alright, let's use the safe. Ellie? Ellie, why are you walking around in circles? Stop that. Ellie! There we go. There are some occasions where the characters will just get stuck in an animation loop, and that can be kind of frustrating at points, but it's not game-breaking. Sometimes it's even hilarious too. I was watching Angry Joe's stream of The Last of Us 2 earlier, and I swear, other Joe just dodged to the point where he fell off a cliff and died. It was freaking hilarious. But anyway, that's going to be the end of Part 7 of The Last of Us Part 2. Tune in for Part 8 where Ellie actually gets a move on and we meet our first few human enemies of the game. I'll see you then.